Hello everyone and welcome back to Genie Crafts. In today's video, we are going to look at part 2 of multi-sided 3D light box. In part 1, we had discussed how to create the 3D structure, and today we are going to see how we can add the images to create the actual template for your multi-sided 3D light box. So guys, let's get started. So the theme for this light box is Christmas and New Year, and the way a multi-sided light box works is that each side of the 3D light box is a individual light box in itself, and you can create a story across the four sides, or you can create a split scene across the four sides. So in this case, this is not a split scene light box, but each side of the light box will represent a story in itself or a complete light box in itself. So the front faces of all the cubes that are sitting inside each other are going to represent one light box. The back faces are going to represent another light box. The left and right faces are going to represent two more light boxes, and the top will represent an altogether different light box. So on the front, I'm going to write or cut out Merry Christmas at the very outermost light box. Then in the second cube, we are going to show Santa in his cart being dragged by reindeers on the snow, and then on the next cube we are going to show some pine trees, and then on the next cube we are going to show some more pine trees. So that will constitute of the four layers of the light box for the front face. The last layer, as I told before in the previous video, is a buffer layer just to soften the effect of the light that will be at the center light pole. So there will be no cutout on the last layer. So download relevant images from the internet, do your research, and try to download silhouette or vector images only with transparent background. But even if you don't have transparent background, even then Microsoft PowerPoint has the ability to get rid of the background, especially if it is in a single color, so don't worry about that. So download the images, copy the images, and then start putting it on the respective slides. So complete one side of the light box at a time. Do not work on all four sides simultaneously. In my case, I'll first work on the front slide. So like the outermost cube, or the first cube, has the Merry Christmas written at the top, which you saw me that I have already arranged. Then on the next cube, I have the reindeer. So right now on the screen, I am arranging the reindeer. So copy paste the image and then send it to the back so that the frame of your cube or the frame of the side is at the top and the image is at the back. Also, this thin border, the strip border that you see on each face, is where you are not going to cut anything. So nothing is going to be cut inside the border. Everything that you are going to cut is in the white area in space. So like you see that I'm arranging the images right now and resizing the images so that it fits inside the frame that you have already created. Also, to set the transparent color, choose set transparent colors in the color option in shape format and click on the color which you want to remove. So in this case, I want to remove the white color of the images so that I can see where the images are being placed, and try to ensure that all the images are connected to each other, or in one way or other they are connected to the border or connected to the other images on the frame. So as you can see that I am working on the front faces of each of the cubes before I am moving on to the any other side of the cube. So first I worked on the layer number 1 where I put Merry Christmas, then on layer number 2 where I put Santa and the reindeer, and then on the layer number 3 front face I am going to put some pine trees on top of a ground. So first I'll arrange the image of the ground, and I'm going to flip it horizontally or vertically as per my need. Like I said before, if you want to set the transparent color, then click on the image for which or where you want to set the transparent color. Go to the shape format option at the top, or in the picture format there is a color section on the left hand top corner. So you can click on that color section, and from there you will see at the very bottom in the menu you will see an option of set transparent color, which will allow you to set the transparent color. So select set transparent color and click on the white area which you want to get rid of, so it will remove the white color from your image. So that's how you can set the transparent color. Also, as you move one layer after another inside the light box, you have to ensure that whatever is in the innermost layer is visible at the front. So arrange the height of the images or the size of the images accordingly. So in my case, I have just put ground with some, you know, pine trees at the two layers. So I'll ensure that the orientation of the ground is reversed to each other in layer number 3 and layer number 4, so that both the hills are properly visible. So that's how you arrange the images. So continue this process for layer number 4 also, where and again I'm simply going to arrange ground and some pine trees. In case you are not sure how your layers are going to look together, so in that case you can copy the contents of layer number 2, 3 and 4 along with the frame of the site together on top of layer number 1 and keep sending them back and back and back. So copy layer number 2 on top of layer number 1, then send the entire content back and do it with layer number 3 and 4. And if you're not able to visualize properly, then you can change the color of the images slightly in the picture format section using the color correction. So you can make it orange, blue, etc, etc, and then you can check out how it is going to look together. If you are happy, then undo all the changes that you have done on layer number 1 and you are ready with one side of your multi-sided light box. In a similar fashion, you have to work upon rest of the sides also based on the theme that you have in your mind. So like I said, build the other sides also. So I have shown snapshots of how I built the other sides in fast forward mode, so you can look at this entire time lapse and see how I built rest of the sides of the light box also. So while you are watching that, some key points that you need to take into account, that this video I have just made for tutorial purpose and for representation sake. Your actual designs need not be so simplistic. In fact, if you are good at sketching, then in that case you can take a printout of empty 3D structure that you have created on the slides and you can sketch on your own what kind of design you want to cut out. So it's not necessary that you have to depend upon the freely available images on the internet. In fact, it is very difficult to find the right kind of image that you want to design in your light box. A lot of time you will have to compromise if you are just dependent upon those freely available images. So this is just for representation's sake. This is not the best way of designing a light box, but it is a easy way of designing a light box if you are not good at sketching and you cannot draw all too well. So in that case you can utilize the different images, vector images, silhouette images that are available on the internet, and you can utilize that to create your own light box design. Also, while I have not shown in this video, once you are done with arranging the images, you can select all the objects or all the images that are present on a single slide, right click and group them so that it becomes a single image for any given slide. This will help you not to accidentally disturb the orientation of the images. One last thing, once you are done with arrangement of the images, then clearly mention on each of the slide or each of the faces that you have created for the light box for the different sides, clearly mention that whether you are going to cut out the dark areas or you are going to cut out the light areas, so that if you are giving this template to somebody else, they clearly know what to cut and what to keep. So that is important. I forgot to show this in the video, but you have to do that. So in the next part, where I'm going to show you how to build this light box, you will see it clearly written on my template what to cut and what not to cut. Finally, save your file as a PDF and your template is ready. And this was my second attempt. In the next part, where I'm going to show you how to build this light box, I'll be utilizing the first attempt that I had at making this template. So I'll be utilizing that template. So guys, I hope you found this video useful. If you guys liked this video, then please do not forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. Also, do subscribe to my channel for regular videos on paper arts. And I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, and bye-bye.